some more like a live work. And do you see the presentation?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so yesterday we've been discussing about the variable volume system. So the variable volume system, it is about the change in volume of the particular the reactant or the product or the total moles which is present in the system during some change in its reaction mechanism, or we say in the unit process. Okay, so this change in unit process the volume of the particular product in the specified dimension has to be come into this our rate equation. Okay, that is what we are trying to explain here. And the main part is here is that the first thing is that how we are going to calculate that. So this can be done by using the change in volumes. So you know that the ideal gas law, that once there is a change in volume will be directly proportional to the temperature and pressure, but in this case we keep the change in pressure and temperature as a variables, and we see how the volume is been changing. Okay, so we take for example PV equal to nRT, and here there is a V naught, and this can be written as V naught by P as one term, and T by V naught on the other term. Okay, and we say the V naught. So this the change in the volume will be directly proportional to the change in the partial pressure and also the temperature, and with that the overall volume of the system. Okay, so here the change in partial pressure means this is definitely will say about mostly for the gas phase reactions. For the gas phase reactions, we have that partial pressure is the main term which is being calculated directly in terms of the concentration. Okay, so that means the change in volume will be more dependent, or more will be formed, will be happen in the gas phase mechanism. Okay, gas phase reaction. Okay, so this can be written as we say XCA means, or we put XCA and the epsilon A. That means XCA is the conversion of A. For example, A gives B. A gives product as the reaction. We assume this as the reaction, and XA is the conversion. Epsilon A is the fractional change in volume. So this fractional change in volume has to be calculated based on the change in volume. That means the change in total number of moles of reaction system when reaction is complete. Okay, so that is what we said. So it is the volume can be written as V at conversion is 1, that is 100%, minus V at the conversion is 0, because the starting volume and the final volume divided by the initial volume, that is the V XA equal to 0. That is what we say. So that means we can just put V and V naught by V naught, just for our sake, okay, for our understanding. So if we rewrite this, then we say that V naught into XA into epsilon A equal to V minus V naught. So then V equal to V naught plus V naught XA into epsilon A. So then we can write V equal to V naught 1 plus xA into f small a. This is what the term we get when they're corresponding to the change in fractional value. Okay, the fractional change in volume. Okay, this is what we get. We just try to convert this in our concentration term. So that is a very important one. So we need to convert this into the concentration term. But in the concentration term, we actually already discussed about the constant volume system, where we said the number of moles, that we take the conversion is the number of moles initially supplied to the total number of moles it's finally attained, divided by the number of moles initially attained for a A, for this particular reaction. Okay, we are trying to write it this way. So this can be written as, again, NA. Okay. So if we take as a vice versa, NA will be equal to NA naught 1 minus XA. Okay. This is what the term we attain for the actual number of moles which is converted. Okay. This is what the value that we can easily calculate by using the conversion term. Okay. So if that is the case, then if you want to put this particular change in volume into this term, so we take the concentration term here. So concentration term will be Ta by V. Okay, or Va, we can say this something. So this can be written as Na. So this term will come here. So this term will come here, and this term will come here. That means we put Na naught 1 minus XA divided by V naught 1 plus XA epsilon A. So this can be a little more simplified, because this is the total number of moles initially being present and the total volume of the system. So that can be written as the initial concentration, that is the total volume that initially taken in the reactor. Okay. So the initial concentration of the reactant can be included in the terms of like this. So this is what we use for the concentration term in case if you are representing with the rate law or the power law equations. Okay. So this particular concentration term can be utilized for our rate law equation. Okay. So now we have discussed with many different problems yesterday, and we have been discussing some more thing today too. So I just want to clarify the yesterday's problem. I hope like everybody can see the particular problem in this PDF file, that A plus B, it says that A plus half B gives C. Okay, where so this is a gas-phase reaction takes place in a reactor. A stoichiometry mixture of A and B at 300 Kelvin. That means the temperature, it says at 300 Kelvin. 300 Kelvin is fed to the reactor at 1 meter along the length of the reactor. Okay, so that means it is the 300, this is 300, T naught. The temperature is 360 Kelvin. Once you fed in that, then it's a, T will be 360 Kelvin. So actually, once it's fit, it is 300. Okay, the temperature is 360 degree. The pressure drop is negligible here. That means the P and P naught will be negligible. Or we just omit that. Okay, at an ideal gas behavior can be assumed. Identify the correct expression here. So we need to represent here. So we need to represent what is Ca naught. And also we need to represent what is the epsilon A. That is what they have required here. So that is what they were trying to express here. So what we know that the volume of change in volume would be V equal to V naught E by P naught V naught by P is the one term that we need to clarify here. So that means for V equal to V naught, what is the temperature here? That is V equal to V naught 300 divided by 360. So this is approximately 0.833, right? So 0.833 V naught. So this is what the value we have found. So what is epsilon A? Epsilon A can be calculated as, it is the product is 1 and the reactant is 1 plus 1 by 2 divided by 1. Because the conversion is actually maximum minus the reactant which has been initially substituted into this mechanism. So this will be 1 minus, so this will be 3 by 2, then it will be approximately 1 by, minus 1 by 2. So this can be written as minus 0.52, okay. So once you substitute this here, because the concentration change will be there is a change in volume. That means Ca will be 0.833 Ca naught, because Ca naught, because the Na naught divided by the Va naught will be Ca naught, and 1 minus Xa. And 1 minus 0.5 XA. So this would be the answer for the yesterday's problem we have asked you to do this. I hope this could be clear, and you can take it down if you want. And if you have any doubt, you can request us. So we will. We are actually happy to clarify you. Any doubt would be appreciated. Mm-hmm. Okay. I hope you guys actually cleared out here now, and we'll go with another one more problem with a similar case. I want to make it more clear here, and we take a problem. Consider the isothermal gas phase reaction gas phase reaction precipitate. Calculate the fractional change in volume. Number one, consider it's a pure reactant, and for A gives 3P. So please calculate the fractional change in volume for this particular reaction here. So, in this case, we actually need to find the fractional change in volume. That means the total product which is actually at the 100% conversion, and the number of moles will be 3 and 1. One will be the reactant where there is the conversion is at the initial stage divided by 1. So that will be, so the change in fractional or the fractional change in volume would be 2 here. And we take the next case. There is one more problem which is been given here. For the reaction A gives 4R, K contain a 40 mole of A and 60 mole percent of initially. So this can be represented in a very simple way that you have the 4 moles actually in the product and 1 mole in the reactant. So how do we do this? Is we take as a at A initially or we take it initial and we take it as final. In initial we have A and we have an inert. In initial, we have A and we have an inert. And finally, we have R. So, how we are going to represent this? Is that we consider this is the basis will be 100 moles. Okay. So we take the basis as the 100 moles, and once we take as 100 moles, here it says that the 40 mole percent of A, that means it is 40 mole, which is present in our initial case, and the inert is a 60 mole, okay, and there is no R present in the initial step. Okay, so this will be 100. So the total will be 100 at the initial stage. Okay, now we go into the final term, and in the final term there is no A because A completely converts into the product. That means it is 0. Because at the final stage, we take the conversion is at the maximum. Conversion is here at the, we take xc equal to 100%. Once we are actually dealing with the fractional change. Fractional change in volume, that means that we take it at the initial as the 0% conversion, and at the final stage we take it as the 100% conversion. Okay. So once we take it 100% conversion, that means there is no E present. And how much the inert will be? It is 60 mole, okay, because we took the 100 mole as the base. And how much R present here? That means here 1 mole of A converts into 4 moles of R. That means the 40 moles will be converted into 4 into 4, that is the 40 into 4 times. So it will be 160. Okay, this will be 160. So this 160 moles will be the moles of R which is present. Okay. So if you total this will be 220 moles. So the total number of moles that is present in the final stage will be 220. So we check the fractional volume change here. So the initial is 100. It is actually the final from the initial, right? So the final is 220. Initial divided by the initial one. That means we take it as 120 divided by 100. It is 1.2. So here the fractional change will be 1.2. That is 1.2 times it is higher in its volume. That's all. But there is a 1 mole converts into 4 moles of product, but the actual change in volume would be only 1.2 times. Is not one, I mean 4 times. Why? Because we have the inert. Inert is just carry over with our reactor here. Okay, so that we need to check the actual volume. If you want to check the actual volume, then this is the case. I mean, this is how you will check the actual volume change in the reactor. So why we do this is that this value will give an approximate increase in the volume of the content in the reactor. So this change in volume will show you how much bigger the reactor need. Even though you have a base of an 100 mole, but the actual increase in volume will be 1.2 times. So we need to represent, or we need to go for the design as the 1.2 times the size of the actual flow which comes into the system. Okay, this is what we are actually very much curious here to actually see what, the particular term called the fractional change in volume. Okay. So the next one we will check with them and another very good problem, because that will be most often being discussed. I hope everybody is very clear here. Just find the problem here. Find the first order. Find the first order reaction, okay? With rate constant K preferred to A. Okay, so this is just referred to A. option. To A is product, or B, if on holding the pressure constant, if I'm holding the pressure constant, the volume of the reaction mixture, the volume of the reaction mixture starting with % of A, okay, and 20% of inerts decreases by 20 minutes, in 3 minutes. Okay, this is what the question has been asked here, and now we need to find out the epsilon A here. So the epsilon A can be calculated in the simple way that how I explained before, that we take it as the 80 mole of A, that is the initial stage, and the final, and here A and the inerts and the product. So this will be taken as, we take 80 moles, the base is 100, and we take 20 molars inert, and there is a zero product, and here similarly 20 mole comes in the product. Here there is no A, that is what we are going to understand, and here 2 moles of A converts into 1 mole of A. That means only 40 moles actually converted. That means here it is 100 and here it is 60. So if you want to calculate epsilon A, it will be 60 minus 100 by 100 equal to minus 0.4. Here the volume change can go in a negative or in the positive. Okay, that is what we have discussed yesterday in class. So that we can go in the negative or in the positive. That doesn't mean. So now, I mean, the reaction mechanism says that it is a first order reaction. So that means we have to know what is the empirical formula that we derived previously for the first order kinetics. For any A gives a product, the first order kinetics will be the ln 1 minus xA equal to kT. Here the change in volume has to be calculated soon here. Okay. So at the time 3 minutes, it says 20% decrease in its volume. So we need to know exactly how much volume it's been decreased. So we need to find out what is xA here. XA can be calculated on the basis of V minus V naught divided by epsilon A into V naught. I hope everybody remember this. This comes from where we have already wrote that epsilon A XA equal to V minus V naught by V naught. Okay, so that means the change in volume, that is change in volume will be 20%. So there is a decrease in volume, that is V minus V naught. V minus V naught will be 0.2 change in volume. Yeah, 0.2 is the decrease, that means 0.8 into V naught. So this is the change in volume. So this is the decrease in volume, that is what it's been mentioned in the previous thing. So if that is the case, then the at delta V equal to actually the 20% change. Okay, so that is we have to keep it in our mind. So this we need to keep it in our mind. That is what it's been mentioned here. And once the change in volume, like everything, we kept it here, and we know time is at 3 minutes. 3 minutes. Now we know XA. To know the XA, we know these terms, everything, and we know the T. So now we have to find only the K, that is minus ln 1 minus XA. Divided by T. So the XA can be written as this term. That is that the so this term can be written like this as XA is delta V divided by into V naught divided by time. So this can be written as minus ln 1 minus epsilon A. Epsilon A will be 0.4, right? Epsilon A will be 0.4, and the change in volume will be 0.2 divided by 0.4. This is all in the minus now. Yes. And divided by the time is 3 minutes. So now if you substitute, this will be approximately, will come as 0.231 minute inverse. Okay, so this is what the actual calculation, and here the conversion will be 1, I mean the maximum will be 1. So this is how you need to calculate it. So there is a change in volume is actually only 0.8%, because 20% decrease. So the change in volume will be 20% decreased. So that means it is only 0.8. So if you substitute this here, then we get 0.2. So this is a minus 0.2 here. And the epsilon value will be minus 0.4. And the V naught is just 1, because that is what we took as the actual volume. Okay. Because we consider as the 1 volume, and from 1 it is actually down to 0.8. Okay. So this substitution will give the value as a K equal to 0.231. per minute as the actual value. Okay.